Dear students, so far we have studied about all five properties. Now today we are going for property number 6. So here property number 6 is property number 6. So what this property number? First let me give some basic idea about the property number 6. Suppose here you see, in this case, suppose see, first we consider 2 by 2 like x plus 2, y plus 3, 5, 6. So this I am giving you for 2 by 2 and 3 by 3. See, look at, in R1, every element is sum of two terms. In R1, every element in R1 is sum of two terms. Therefore, this whole determinant can be written as sum of two determinants. If it is sum of two terms, means this whole determinant can be expressed as sum of two determinants, like what? First x, 5, y, 6, one determinant, plus the second determinant is 2, 3, 5, 6. Same, it can be extended for third order also. What is the conclusion of property number 6 is, if every element in any determinant, or in any determinant, every element of any row or column is expressed as sum of two terms, then the whole determinant can be expressed as sum of two determinants. Whole determinant can be written as sum of. First here what? X, Y, 5, 6, one determinant. And second is 2, 3, 5, 6. Suppose I'll go for this. Once again it is C. This is the one. X plus A, Y plus B, Z plus C. And again here Y, Z, X, Y, and X. But look at this. This is the third order determinant. Here, the column one, in the column one, every term is sum of two terms. Then this whole determinant can be expressed as sum of two determinants. So here in this, sum of two determinants means what? First determinant is what? X, Y, Z. Next is what? Y, X, Y, Z, Y, X. First determinant. And second determinant is like this. A, B, C, column 1 and column 2 and column 3 remain same. Y, X, Y and Z, Y, X. So again, in any determinant, every element of any row or any column is expressed as sum of two terms means, then this whole determinant can be expressed as sum of two determinants. That means sum of two determinants is, first determinant is what? X, Y, Z, Y, X, Y, Z, Y, X, one determinant. And second determinant is what again? With the blue ink I am going to see. Second determinant is what? A, B, C, again Y, X, Y, Z, Y, X. If it is sum of two terms, every element is sum of two terms means sum of two determinants. Sum of three terms means three determinants. So sum of four terms means Suppose it is C. Now we can write x plus y plus z, or y plus x plus z, z plus x plus y, b, c, a, b, and c, a. Suppose this is the determinant. Look here. In this, in the column 1, every element is sum of three terms. Then it will be expressed as sum of three determinants. 1, 2, and 3. It can be expressed as sum of three determinants. So first one is column wise, x, y, z. X, y, z. Second row will be same here. Second row will be same here. And third row will be same. Again, here. First y, x, y, x, x, and again second row, second column, third column will remain same. And again here third, z, z, y, z, z, y, and again second row and third row will be same. But the proof will be for only sum of two terms. Similarly, it can be going for sum of three terms. So the final conclusion about property number 6. In any determinant, if every term in a row or column is sum of, expressed as sum of two terms or more, then the whole determinant can be expressed as sum of two determinants or more. So this we have to prove now. So this is the property number 6. Now look at here, sum of two terms, how it can be. Look at this. So property number 6, okay. Now we'll see this is. So proof of this property number 6, you can write here, property 6. So the property number 6 is what? In any determinant, if every element of any row or in the bracket column, every element of any row is expressed as sum of two terms, then whole determinant can be expressed as sum of two determinants. So this is the, suppose see, we have to prove that now, like question wise, we have to prove that. Suppose every term is like this, a1 plus x, a2 plus y, A3 plus Z, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. This is, so observe this. In this, so we have to prove that A1 plus X. In this, see, in this, every element in this, every element in the first row, every element in the first row is sum of two terms. Definitely this whole determinant, this whole determinant can be expressed as sum of two determinants. First one is what? A1 row wise, no? A2, A3, 1, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3, first determinant, plus the second determinant is, the second determinant is, the second determinant is again, in the row wise you are writing, that is what? X, Y, Z, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. So now we have to prove this one. Prove that. Now we'll take here what happened in this case. We have to express as sum of two determinants now. LHS will take now. Here the derivation is like this. So LHS, now you take it now. Here on the L take. This is LHS now. This is the LHS and sum of two determinants. A1, A2. So LHS is what? A1 plus X, A2 plus Y, A3 plus Z, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Now we have to prove that this can be, this whole determinant, this LHS determinant can be expressed as sum of two determinants. If it is sum of three terms, determinants, sum of three terms, three determinants. So expanding in now, first row only. Now I'll go for expanding first row. In the first row, here, look at this. In the first row, plus and minus and again plus. So we are expanding from this thing, expanding along R1. Expanding along R1. Along R1. That is what? Plus A1 X into A1. A1 plus X into B2 C3. B2 C3. Minus B3 C2. Minus B3 C2. Minus A2 plus Y into A2 plus Y means complete here. You see A2 plus Y. Horizontal get cancelled. Vertical get cancelled. B1 C3 minus C1 B3. B1 C3 minus C1 B3 or B3 C1. B3 C1. Plus third, that's A3 plus Z. A3 plus Z. Here it is. See, we are directly, I'll write here. This is row cancelled, column. B1 C2 minus B2 C1. So this is LHS is equal to LHS. Now I'll write this is. So in this, you can pause the video and write, no problem, later on. Yes. Sum of two determinants you have to go. Yes, in this. Yes. Now look at this. Here, first simplification is, look at B2 C3 minus B3 C2. First you multiply by A1. And again minus A2. B1 C3 minus B3 C1 by A2, you first multiply it. And again B1 C2 minus B2 C1, you multiply by A3. Afterwards, now first with black color, what I have written is LHS is equal to, look here. LHS is equal to, first with A1 we are multiplying A1 into B2 C3, B2 C3minus B3 C2, minus B3 C2, minus A2 into, minus A2 into B1 C3, B1 C3 minus B3 C1, B3 C1. Next, plus A3 into, plus A3 into B1 C2, B1 C2 minus B2 C1, minus B2 C1. Next, again, now in this, afterwards, remaining is one more. Again, B2 C3 minus B3 C2 by X once now. Again, here minus Y. B1 C3 minus B3 C1, again multiply by Y now. And again, B1 C2 minus B2 C1 by Z. So we have to continue now. Plus X into, plus X into B2 C3, B2 C3 minus B3 C2, B3 C2 minus Y into B1 C3, B1 C3 minus B3 C1 plus Z into, plus Z into B1 C2 minus B2 C1. Look at, my dear students, this entire black color what I have written here, entire black color, this is, I told you, it is an open umbrella, but this open umbrella can be closed. I can close it like this. Look at here, this open umbrella. Can anybody tell me now, this one we can write like this, LHS is equal to, I can write like this, A1, A2, A3, this is in first row. This is A1, A2, A3. This is for second row and third row. Definitely, here A1 into A1, horizontal get cancelled, vertical. That means here B2, here will be B2, and here it will be C3. And definitely here B2 means it is here C2, and here it is A2, and here it is B3, and this is A3. Now you check it once again. The red color, what I've written here, look at. Plus, again, if you expand first row, A1 into B2 C3 minus B3 C2. Here. Here. Now look at here. A1 into, A1 get cancelled. B2 C3 minus this. Here I've written. And minus A2 into, A2 C3 minus A3 C2. Plus A3 into A2 B3 minus A3 B3. Plus again now in the complete red color. In the red color, in the red color, what is there? In the red color, see, in the red color part, complete this red color part. Now once again you see that. This entire red color part, you can make it one more determinant here. X, again minus Y, Z. This is will be first row. X, Y, Z, and remaining will be same, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. Check it once again whether it is correct or not. Sum of two determinants. Your first determinant it is, and see that X into B2 C3 minus B3 C2. This is correct. This is first row we are expanding, you know, plus minus. Minus Y into, Y into A2 C3 minus A3 C2. Y into, Y into B1 C3, this is A2 B2 C2, and A3 B3 C3 this. So the determinant is given C1, A1 A2, this is sorry B1, this one is sorry, yes. Look here, A1 A2 A3, this will become this will become here. Look at this. B1, B2, B3. C1, C2, C3. First one. Now here, again, this is also here. So remaining will be same now as it is. You can check it now. This is B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Once again, we check it now. X into B2, C3 minus C2, B3. Yes, this is correct. Minus Y into B1, C3 minus C1, B3. Correct. Plus Z into B1, C2. Here I have written B1, C2 minus B2, C1. Here also we'll see. Plus A1 into B2, C3 minus C2, B3 or B2, C3 here. Minus A into plus. Minus A to vertical, horizontal. B1, C3 minus B3, C1. Here I have written plus A3. A3 means B1, C2 minus B2, C1. Here I have written. That is first black, entire black letters what I have written is first determinant. Entire red color letters what I have written is for second. So the conclusion is what? In any determinant, if any row or every element of any row or any column is sum of two terms then or more, then the whole determinant can be expressed as sum of two determinants or more determinants. So this is one small example. Now we can go for this case. You can see that, dear students, hope so, you can now pause the video timely and note down the notes. So light, there will be a small change in the explanation from your textbook. So don't try it. If at all you want to practice from the textbook, you will read. Don't mix up and don't get confused. So last, this is the property number 6. So now, yeah. So finally, just I'll be providing you one example. After that, you'll come to know example it is. See now, one example it is like 2, 3, 4 and 3 plus x, 4 plus y, 5 plus z, and 5, 7, 9. Yes, in this second row, every element is sum of two terms. Therefore, it can be expressed as sum of two determinants. Correct? Sum of what? First one, 2, 3, 4 as it is, we write 2, 3, 4. Next here, first terms we write here, 3, 4, and 5. So 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5. Write third row as it is, 5, 7, 9. Next again, first row same it is, 2, 3, 4. Now here, second, x, y, z. So x, y, z, and 5, 7, 9. That's all. So it can be applied in column also. Thank you, dear students. Now we'll go for property number 7. Before property number 7, so that is the main most of the problems we are going to solve on property number, last property only. So that has to be studied well. Better we spend some good time to understand the property number 7 through example, then we'll go for the derivations. Thank you. Thank you, dear students.